हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू मदर वेलंकनी इंग्लिश स्कूल एंड जूनियर कॉलेज। होप यू ऑल आर कीपिंग वेल एंड सेफ। माय सेल्फ भक्ति पांडे, टुडे आई विल बी टीचिंग यू इंग्लिश सब्जेक्ट चैप्टर नंबर 1.1, दैट इज एन एस्ट्रोलॉजर्स डे, रिटन बाय आर के नारायण। नाउ बिफोर स्टार्टिंग आर टुडेज टॉपिक, लेट अस नो अबाउट Mr. R. K. Narayan, the writer of this story. R. K. Narayan, his full name was Rasipuram Krishnaswamy Iyer Narayan Swami. He was born on 10th October 1906 and died on 13 May 2001. Okay, writer R. K. Narayan is one of the best novelists in Indian English literature. He had wrote 14 novels which had been published, 5 volumes of short stories have been published, also many travelogues, and also a memoir named My Days. Now memoir means something that is written by own experience, okay? Now he wrote memoir My Days, which was then transformed into a serial, a very known serial, very famous serial named Malgudi Days. You all must be knowing Malgudi Days. In his writings, you could see a very nice blending of simplicity, touch of Indianness, you can say, okay, humor, also along with compassion. His famous novel named The Guide, it was his one of the famous novel which was being awarded. He had received many awards and honors as such. Let us quickly read out this. R. K. Narayan, 1906 to 2001, Rasipuram Krishnaswamy Iyer Narayan Swami was one of the best known novelists among Indian English writers. He is the author of 14 novels, 5 volumes of short stories and a number of travelogues, and has a collection of non-fiction to his credit. He also wrote his memoir, My Days, 1975. Narayan created the imaginary town of Malgudi, where realistic characters in a typically Indian setting lived amid unpredictable events. His stories are grounded in compassionate humanism and celebrated the humor and energy of ordinary life. His stories are characterized by a simple style and subtle humor. As I said, in his each and every writings, there used to be a sense of humanity, a sense of Indianness, okay, and a sense of simplicity. Narayan was introduced to American readers in 1952 by the Michigan State University Press. This includes Swami and Friends, Bachelor of Arts, Dark Room, and Astrologer's Day, other stories, Mr. Sampat, the Financial Expert, Waiting for the Mahatma, The Guide, and many other books. His novel, as I said you, The Guide, it is one of the famous novel, won him the Sahitya Academy Award in 1961, the most coveted literary honor in India. His writing is distinguished by humor and unoffending irony, a unique Indianness, and a simplicity which is utterly charming and authentic. Narayan typically portrays the peculiarities of human relationships and the ironies of Indian daily life. His style is graceful, marked by genial humor, elegance, and simplicity. Let's start our today's very interesting topic named An Astrologer's Day, written by R. K. Narayan. Now, before starting, let me tell you, this topic includes two important characters. Getting it? Two important characters, mainly astrologer, and secondly, the second person is Guru Nayak. First is astrologer, second is Guru Nayak. Now, you all must be knowing what is astrology, aren't you? And who is called an astrologer, right? So, let me tell you. Astrology means study of position and movements of stars and planets and the way some people believe they affect people and events. Okay, what does it mean? Study of position and movements of stars and planets and way some people believe they affect on people and events. We all know Rashifal and all, Bhavishyavani, Rashifal and all. So it is nothing but it is study of stars and planets. And then we see the effect of it on various zodiac signs, right? And who is the astrologer? Astrologer is a person who is very expert in astrology, who has the knowledge of astrology, who has the knowledge of movement of or position of stars and planets, okay, is the astrologer. Now, In this topic, An Astrologer's Day, the first character astrologer is actually not a real knowledgeable person, okay? But he is a fake astrologer, we can say, having nil or zero knowledge about astrology. Means he has not studied astrology as such. He is not having any knowledge about astrology. But he is an astrologer. We all must have seen Dongi Babas and all, of course. So same, he is not Dongi Baba, but still, he is doing his work just for the sake of earning. And so he has become an astrologer. Other than choosing any other profession, he chose being an astrologer. Now, just for the sake of earning, he does this work of astrology, okay? Otherwise, this man never wanted to be an astrologer in his life. But due to some circumstances which took place in his life, he had to choose astrology as his profession. As I said, students, this is going to be a very interesting and, let me tell you, a suspense story, okay? So let's get started with the story. An astrologer's day. Punctually at midday, he opened his bag and spread out his professional equipment, which consisted of a dozen cowrie shells. Punctually at midday means what? We all know what is punctuality, being on time, okay? So at midday, midday means afternoon. So every day he was very punctual. Every day in the afternoon, he used to open up his bag, spread out his professional equipment. Spread out his professional equipment means what? Every day in his daily routine, he opened his bag and removed his equipment. Means his professional related things. Whatever he required for his profession, for astrology, those things he used to remove. Okay? Which consisted of a dozen cowrie shells. Cowrie means what? A sea animal. We have seen near beach side and all, we have seen shells, okay, lying out. So those shells he used to carry. A square piece of cloth with obscure mystic charts on it. Now, square piece of cloth, we all know. What is obscure? Obscure means which is not understandable, actually difficult to understand, not clear, okay? And mystic means something that relates to supernatural powers and is not easily understood. We, the common people, we cannot understand those supernatural powers, okay? Only the people who have knowledge into it, only they can understand. So it was somewhat like that, a square piece of cloth with obscure mystic charts made on it, some drawings or something as such, which we cannot understand actually. A notebook and a bundle of Palmyra writing. What is Palmyra? Please do underline these words, okay? And you can write down the meaning as well. It is a type of a khajur leaf, I can say, a leaf on which something has been written on it, okay? Now, after this, see, the writer describes the character sketch, the astrologer's sketch, how he used to look, okay? His forehead was resplendent with sacred ash and vermilion. Forehead means the front part of our head, okay, was resplendent. What is resplendent? Bright, as it is given over here, bright, dazzling and impressive. It was very bright and attractive, okay? So resplendent with sacred ash. Sacred means holy. Ash means what? We all must be knowing, incense stick, agarbatti. So the rag of it is called as ash, okay? And vermilion. Vermilion means what? The red colored kumkum or tika, which mostly we apply on the head, okay? And his eyes sparkled with a sharp abnormal gleam. Means what? Means sparkling eyes, very bright. His eyes were very bright and attractive. So his eyes sparkled with a sharp abnormal gleam, which was really an outcome of a continual searching look for customers. Means what he used to do? He used to continuously search for customers so that customers would come and he could earn his livelihood, but which his simple clients took to be a prophetic light and felt comforted. Means what? Prophet means, we all know, a very intelligent person, or we can say a future teller, okay? So customers, because of his sparkling eyes, they used to get attracted and they used to feel comforted. Means what? They used to be very happy with the advices or solutions which the astrologer used to give, okay? Then, the power of his eyes was considerably enhanced by the position placed as they were between the painted forehead and the dark whiskers which streamed down his cheek. Considerably enhanced means what? Means were noticeable, okay? It were actually noticeable by their positions. Eyes were actually noticeable as they were between what? Painted forehead. Now, why it is said painted forehead? Because it means ash and vermilion. It was painted with the ash and vermilion. So, painted forehead, which was attractive. Dark whiskers. Dark whiskers means what? either beard or mustache, okay? So, which streamed down his cheeks, even a half-wit's eyes would sparkle in such a setting. Half-wit's eyes, underline it. Half-wit's eyes means what? Means someone or some person who is disabled by brain development. We all must be knowing autistic people, okay? Who are actually, their development of brain is actually less than the common people, okay? So, but their eyes do sparkle a lot. There is some other sort of energy in their eyes. So, similarly, the writer has compared it with the half-wit's eyes would sparkle in such a setting. To crown the effect, he wound a saffron-colored turban. Crown. Crown means what? The king wears a crown, right? So the effect, he wound a saffron-colored. Saffron means orange-colored turban. That is pagdi, around his head. This color scheme never failed. Now why he is telling this? Because this color scheme was very attractive. Orange, pagdi, red, vermilion, then ash. Okay, so it was very attractive and this never failed. This actually attracted the customers. People were attracted to him as bees are attracted to cosmos or dahlia stalks. Stalks means what? Stem or branch of flowers. Okay, flower stem. So, bees means madhumakhi and all. The way the madhumakhi and all, the bees are attracted towards the flowers. Similarly, customers used to get attracted to the astrologer. He sat under the boughs of a spreading tamarind tree. Where did he sit? Under the boughs of a spreading tamarind. Tamarind means imli. Imli ka jhaad. He used to sit under the tamarind tree which flanked a path running through the town hall park. Town hall park is the market. Okay. So, he used to sit nearby the market under a tamarind tree. It was a remarkable place in many ways. Okay. It was very remarkable place means noticeable place. Very famous place. Okay. A surging crowd was always moving up and down this narrow road from morning till night. Now, hear what the writer is doing. Writer is actually is creating the image of the market wherein the astrologer used to sit. Okay, a surging. Surging means what? Very crowded, where people actually push each other and move forward due to rush or crowd. Now, we all must be knowing the rush or crowd at the platforms, railway platforms or in the market. We all might have seen. So, people actually push other people to move forward. So it is called as surging crowd. A variety of trades and occupations was represented all along its ways. Medicine sellers of stolen hardware and junk, magicians and above all. Now here the writer is saying this kind of stores were over there. Variety of trades were over there. Medicine seller, hardware, junk, magician, above all auctioner of cheap cloth. Auctioner of cheap cloth means where the cloth is sold out in a very less rate and all. Who created enough din all day to attract the whole town. Din means what? Din means loud noise, okay? Actually in the market we all must have heard, it is very noise polluted, right? Then next to him in vociferousness came a vendor of fried groundnut. What happened where the astrologer used to sit under the tree? Next to him, who came? A fried groundnut seller, vendor of fried groundnuts. Vociferousness means what? Something that is of loud noise, okay? So, the groundnut seller used to come and shout in a loud voice. Who gave his ware a fancy name in each day? His ware means his things, which the stuff which he used to sell, the fried groundnuts, he used to name it in a different ways every day, such as Bombay ice cream one day, next day Delhi almond, third day Raja's delicacy, okay, and so on and so forth. And people flocked to him, and because of such different type of names, people used to actually gather near him. Okay, a considerable portion of this crowd dallied before the astrologer too. Dallied means move towards. So, because of his shouting, the fried groundnut sellers shouting, people used to gather over there and then move towards the astrologer too. The astrologer transacted his business by the light of a flare which crackled and smoked up above the groundnut heap nearby. What happened? He was not having his own light, okay? He did his business under the light of flare which crackled and smoked. How? Which light? The groundnut seller used to fry his groundnuts, okay? Under that fire, under the light, fire's light, this astrologer used to transact his business. Half the enchantment of the place was due to the fact that it did not have the benefit of municipal lighting. Means it was very attractive because of that thing only. It was not having any such particular lighting, okay? The place was lit up by shop lights. One or two had hissing gas lights, means old gas lights. Some had naked flares stuck on poles. Naked flares stuck on poles means lanterns. We can say kandil and all. Some were lit up by old cycle lamps, and one or two, like the astrologer, managed without lights of their own. Means the astrologer was not having its own light or own shop. Similarly, one or two were more there who didn't have their own lights. It was a bewildering crisscross of light rays and moving shadows. Bewildering means confusing. The light was coming from here, from there, from left, from right. So it was a crisscross of light rays actually and moving shadows, because people were just continuously moving from there. This suited the astrologer very well, for the simple reason that he had not in the least intended to be an astrologer when he began life. Means what? This suited it because he was not having any sort of investment into it. Okay, it suited it because he was not ready to become an astrologer. He didn't want to become an astrologer when he began his life, and he knew no more of what was going to happen to others than he knew what was going to happen to himself next. Means what? He was not aware about what is actually going to happen to himself in the next minute. Then how would he advise, or how would he know about other customers' future, right? He was as much as stranger to the stars as were his innocent customer. As we common public, we do not know anything about the stars and planets, okay, about astrology. Similarly, he was also not aware about the stars and planets, okay. Yet he said things which pleased and astonished everyone. That was more a matter of study, practice and shrewd guesswork. Means what? He was not having any knowledge, but due to proper practice, he used to astonish everyone that yes, you gave the correct answer, but it was just a mere practice, nothing else. Okay. Shrewd means what? Very accurate guesswork. He used to just guess, tukka lagana, and it used to be correct. Okay. All the same, it was as much as honest man's labor as any other, and he deserved the wages he carried home at the end of the day. Means what? Writer says he earned from his honest efforts and so deserved the income wages to carry home. He had left his village without any previous thought or plan. If he had continued there, he would have carried on the work of his forefathers, namely tilling, land living, marrying and ripening in his cornfield and ancestral home. Means what? He had left his village. He didn't wanted to be astrologer actually, but he had left his village due to some reasons. And after, if he would have lived over there, then he would have done only agriculture and all work, getting married, agriculture, ancestral home ko sambhalna and all. Okay, but that was not to be. He had to leave home without telling anyone. He did not tell anyone, and he left the home, and he could not rest till he left it behind a couple of 100 miles. Means what? Now he cannot see back. Okay, he just left his home without any future plans, nothing, but he cannot move behind. Okay, as he left it behind a couple of 100 miles behind. To a villager, it is a great deal, as if an ocean flowed between. Means what? For a normal person, for a person coming from village, actually it is a very big deal, because he is not having money, he is not having any house, he is not having anyone, he is not knowing anyone, and he is leaving the village just for the sake of earning. So the writer has compared it with ocean flowed between. Now the village is at the one side, he is at the another side, and between is the ocean. He cannot move back, he has to move ahead. He had a working analysis of mankind's troubles, marriage, money and tangles of human ties. Now what does this mean? Working analysis is studied. He had just studied types of problems and their solutional advances. Now the many common types of problems in a person's life are, it can either be marriage, okay, either be money, or tangles of human ties means fight, jhagda and all. Okay, long practice has sharpened his perception. Within 5 minutes he understood what is wrong. Long practice, because now he has done this work since long, astrology, after coming from the village. So now day by day after getting experienced, the practice has been sharpened. Okay, so now he can quickly guess, he can do a shrewd guesswork, okay, and he can give the answers. Within 5 minutes he understood what was wrong. He charged 3 pais per question, never opened his mouth till the other had spoken. Means what? Pais means currency. Now we use rupees, that time it was pais. So he charged how much? 3 pais per question, and he used to keep quiet until the formal person used to speak. He used to allow the formal person to speak for at least 10 minutes. Okay, till the other had spoken for at least 10 minutes, which provided him enough stuff for a dozen answers and advices. Means what? The customer, he used to allow the customer to speak for about 10 minutes. He used to know what is his problem actually, and then he had dozen of answers and advices for it because of his practice. When he told the person before him, gazing at his palm, "In many ways you are not getting the fullest result for your efforts," 9 out of 10 were disposed to agree with him. Means what? We also know these are the common lines. If I say, for example, that you study so much with lot of efforts, but you don't get such good results. Yes, you will agree that, yeah, you study so well, but you're not getting the actual results what you should get. You should get a first rank or as such. Okay. Similarly, he used to tell the customers also that you do so much of efforts, but you're not getting your results. So people used to agree, yeah, we do so much of hard work, but we are not getting our results. So people used to agree. Or he questioned, "Is there any woman in your family, maybe even a distant relative, who is not well disposed towards you?" Means what? We all have some of the other family members who are actually not, whose behavior is actually not proper with us. Okay. Similarly, he used to try out a second option, that is there anyone in your family who is a distant relative who is not well disposed towards you? Or he gave an analysis of character. Third thing what he used to do was directly give analysis of the customer's character, his nature. Most of your troubles are due to your nature. How can you be otherwise with Saturn where he is? Saturn means Shani, we can say. Okay. So you have an impetuous nature and a rough exterior. Impetuous means what? Impulsive nature. Okay. This endeared him to their hearts immediately. Means this used to be very likable sort of thing. Customers used to like this because now he is giving positives about the former person's nature, and now he is telling, because of your good nature you are dealing with such problems. For even the mildest of us loves to think that he has a forbidding exterior. The nuts vendor blew out his flare and rose to go home. This was a signal for the astrologer to bundle up too. Since it left him in the darkness, except for a little shaft of green light which strayed in from somewhere and touched the ground before him. Now what happens? Now, after the whole day has completed, the nuts vendor, means the groundnut wala, used to blow out his flare, means shut off his fire that he used for frying the groundnut, and rose to go home. So this was actually the signal for for astrologer to bundle up, means to wind up. Okay. Now the astrologer used to come to know that now, yes, it's time to go. Since it left him with darkness, because the lights are off, okay, so it left him in darkness, except for a little shaft of green light which strayed in from somewhere and touched the ground before him. He picked up his cowrie shells and paraphernalia. Paraphernalia means what? Large number of small articles used in a particular activity or personal possession, as it is given over here. Simple words, we can say it is the equipments, professional equipments, which he used to carry with him, and was putting them back into his bag when the green shaft of light was blotted out. Blotted out means what? Wiped off. Okay. He looked up and saw a man standing before him. Now what happened? While he was winding off, suddenly he looks up and a man is standing before him while going at home. Okay. So now he looks at him. He sensed a possible client and said, now he thought that he is a customer, and said, "You look so careworn." Careworn means what? Tensed. The customer was looking tensed. "It will do you good to sit down for a while and chat with me." Now the astrologer says, "Please sit down and chat with me. Talk to me and tell me what is your problem." The other grumbled some reply vaguely. Grumbled means angrily. Okay. The customer, who was standing just in front of him, replied vaguely. The astrologer pressed his invitation, whereupon the other thrust his palm under his nose, saying, "You call yourself an astrologer?" The customer who came, now he is in a very angry mood. The astrologer takes his palm to read his palm lines, but the customer says, "You call yourself an astrologer?" The astrologer felt challenged and said, tilting the other palm toward the green shaft of light. Tilting means moving, okay? Towards the light. Now the lights are actually wiped off, so he couldn't see it properly. So what he does, he tilts the palm towards the green shaft of light. Now he has felt challenged. "Why is he telling me so? That do you feel you are an astrologer?" "Yours is a nature," he starts, the astrologer. "Oh, stop that," the other said. Now here, the other said. Let me tell you, the other said means thus. Now here arrives the second character of the story, who is none other than Guru Nanak. Okay. Guru Nayak said, "Oh, stop that. Tell me something worthwhile." Worthwhile means something that is important. Some means of some importance. Okay. So Guru Nayak says, "Tell me something that is worthwhile. Don't say all these bluffing things." Our friend felt pigged. Pig means very irritated and angry. Means who? Astrologer felt very angry. "I charge only 3 pies per question, and what do you get out to be good enough for your money?" Astrologer is telling, "I charge only 3 pies per question. What else do you want for this 3 pies? At this, the other withdrew his arm, took out an ana and flung it out to him, saying, flung it out to him means threw away on his face. "And ana, I have some questions to ask. If I prove you are bluffing, you must return that ana to me with interest." Guru Nayak is saying, "I have some questions to ask. If I prove that you are bluffing," bluffing means doing fraud, okay, "then you will have to return that ana to me along with interest. If you find my answer satisfactory, will you give me 5 rupees? Astrologer is asking for 5 rupees now if I give a proper answer. Guru Nayak says, "No. You'll give me 8 anas. Now, first he asked for 5 rupees, then he's asking for 8 anas, astrologer. So Guru Nayak says, "All right, provided you give me twice as much if you are wrong," said the stranger. Stranger means Guru Nayak, okay? What he says, "All right, I'll give you 8 anas, but if you give me twice as much as I am giving you, if you are wrong," okay? This pact was accepted after a little further argument. Means what? Now they agreed on this thing that, okay, I'll give you 8 anas. Guru Nayak says, "I'll give you 8 anas, but if I prove you that you're wrong, you'll have to give me double of it." Okay? Now they have made an agreement between them as such. So, students, here I'll stop with part 1. Okay? Till now, you might have understood it, I think. So, read the story till here. The next part, I'll continue in the part 2. The rest part of the story, I'll be continuing in part 2. Okay? Till then, take care. Stay safe. Stay home. Thank you. Thank you, students.